All right, for treatment for atrial fib and atrial flutter, it says beta blockers. So if you have a fast atrial fibrillation, you'd want to slow it down. And that's what beta blockers do. If you have an atrial fib and it's a real fast heart rate and medications are not slowing it down, you need to cardioverter.
Cardioverter is like your last choice, you know?
Yes. Yeah. Let's just go through this really quick, and then I have a whole bunch of strips I want to show you and see if you can identify the rhythm. All right, so you have a really fast heart rate. It's greater than 150 per minute. What would you do? Make sure the patient's breathing okay. Give them oxygen if they're hypoxemic. Put them on a monitor. Check their blood pressure. Check their O2 sat. Do they have low blood pressure? Is it messing with their mental state? Do you see signs of shock, like diaphoresis, chest pain? That would mean that they're unstable if you have yes to any of these questions. They have a really fast heart rate and they're unstable, then it says to cardiovert. Consider adenosine. Okay, so maybe you guys can make up some index cards, how you would treat these different arrhythmias. So really fast heart rate, you would want to try, if they're unstable, adenosine first, and then cardiovert if that adenosine doesn't work. Is the QRS wide? You don't understand that at this point, but we're going to talk about it some more. So let's go down. Let's say it's not wide. You could try vagal maneuvers, either the Valsalva effect or the carotid sinus massage. Try some adenosine. If that doesn't work, then you can put them on beta blockers or calcium channel blockers. Okay, so let's go through some strips. Taking these out of the second edition textbook, but they're in the first edition also. Page 272. Do you need me to call out the page number that I'm finding these at, or you're okay with just looking them up yourself? I would like for you to interpret strip number 9. It's the one at the bottom. It's 6 seconds. Can you tell from your chair if it's regular or irregular?
Irregular.
I'm trying something. Give me a second here. No, that's not better. There's just a lot of glare. I thought I could get rid of it for you.
That looks good, yeah.
Does it? Okay. All right, so it's a regular rhythm. What's the rate?
90.
90? So is that normal? Is that normal bradycardic or tachycardic?
Normal.
That's a normal rate. Are there P waves before each QRS? Just one P wave?
Yes.
And the PR interval, can you tell from your chair if it's 5 boxes or less? It's kind of hard to tell, but it looks like it's less than 5 boxes. Okay. And what else? QRS, is that 3 boxes or less?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so what would you call this rhythm?
Normal sinus rhythm.
Very good, normal sinus rhythm. Now look at number 8.
It's going like above this. It's 6% is for cardiac.
Very good. So you notice the rate is slow, but it's a regular rhythm? Got P waves, one before each QRS. The PR interval is about 5 boxes, so that's normal. So everything's normal, it's just a slow rhythm. So you come to the conclusion that it's a sinus bradycardia. Okay, page 274, number 14.
Yeah, that's tachycardia, sinus tachycardia.
How fast is the rate?
130.
130.
Is it 130?
130.
All right, so 130 per minute. Does the R to R intervals look regular?
Yes.
Yeah.
Is there a P wave before each QRS?
Yes.
So it's just a fast rate, everything else is normal. So sinus tachycardia? Page 276, number 22. What do you think?
Sinus.
Sinus, normal sinus rhythm.
Very good, normal sinus rhythm. Everything is normal. Page 315. Okay, number 3.
Oh, atrial fibrillation and.
How did you know? Very good.
The irregular heartbeat. And there's no P waves.
Very good. This is the most missed rhythm. Of all these years that I've been teaching it, if you miss a rhythm on the test, it's usually this one.
This one's most.
This one's almost like stand out.
To me, it's the easiest, it stands out.
Because it has two specific things that you look for.
Yeah.
What page is that?
So you guys are gonna break the spell?
We're gonna break the spell.
Yes, we're gonna break the spell.
You're gonna keep this right? All right, so that's atrial fibrillation. Okay, number 29. Is it regular or irregular?
It's irregular, there's no P waves, so it's atrial fibrillation.
What do you think? Do you see any P waves? You see QRSs.
Yeah, there's a Q. It's just not.
Yeah, those big tall complexes, that's QRS, so you've got QRS. Oh, yeah, most EKGs, you don't see the Q wave.
Yeah, atrial fib.
Yes, so it's irregular, you don't see P waves, it's atrial fibrillation.
Atrial fib's the only one that is irregular, like you said, right? So it's a giveaway. Like as far as the spaces in between.
Yeah.
Yes.
Number 49.
AFib.
Am I overdoing it? Okay, I'll move up. 14, number 8.
What is it?
AFib. Oh, that's the saw one that you said.
Yeah, do you see the sawtooth appearance?
Yeah.
Remember?
Atrial fibrillation.
Which one are you looking at?
8.
Oh, 8.
Number 8.
That was great one. Yeah.
Atrial flutter?
Atrial flutter, very good.
So the saw, safe to say the sawtooth is atrial flutter?
Yes. Number 31. Oh, I guess I'm going in too much of an order here. I'm gonna have to mix it up next time.
Okay.
Yes, you did it already one of them.
Atrial flutter.
Sorry, guys, I didn't know this went in order. 324. Number 46, you're gonna kill me.
Flutter.
Okay, page 316.
Are we gonna have to decipher like these, like, tips on the test?
Yes. Number 15?
SVT.
Is it a regular rhythm?
Yes.
Actually, yeah, it is, because it's P wave, T wave, P wave. It's just.
How fast is the rate?
Sinus tachycardia.
180? Is it normal for the SA node to fire 180 times a minute in adults?
No, 160.
I thought it was.
Up to 160.
Up to 160. So sinus.
Very good. So you know that everything looks normal, so the impulse is originating above the ventricles? But it can't be the SA node, so we'll just call it SVT or atrial tachycardia. Okay. Page 326.
Mm-hmm. PAT.
Very good. Oh, look, there's sudden onset of a fast heart rate. So you've got to use that fancy word.
Proximal. Oh, paroxysmal sinus tachycardia.
Yes. Paroxysmal atrial tachycardia, PAT. All right, you guys get an A.
Yeah. We just got to do that on the test.
Yes. All right, so you'll take lunch, and then we'll... Are you guys ready? Do you feel ready for your test for next week? You'll have a lot of strips. You'll have multiple choice questions. You have to interpret the strips.